Gentlemen, how you doing? Welcome back to the T. Shanley Starting a Business, Building a Brand vlog. This one, big number 156. So last vlog, if you guys missed it, Kelly was here in Atlanta for some business and he was stopping by and so we decided, hey, let's film a vlog. I'm not gonna miss the opportunity of getting some help filming the vlog. And it was a great vlog. There's a lot of information in there about, you know, if you're somebody who is starting a business or potentially may have a product that needs to be manufactured, the whole like, there's so much great information. If you guys missed last week's vlog, 155, you gotta check it out. We also talked about the fact that we are coming out with two deodorants. One is charcoal based, one is I shouldn't say it's charcoal based. It has charcoal, activated charcoal in there that helps with like absorbing like odor and stuff like that. And one that is baking soda based. And we asked for you guys to comment down below which one you'd be more interested in. And it looks like we are going to launch probably both of them. And so the good news is you get to pick. But today I want to talk a little bit about movement watches and why I am so today specifically inspired by the brand and the two gentlemen that started this business. And really the reason why I want to talk about movement is because there's so much incredible information and value from their story and sort of what they've done that I think you guys definitely, it'll give you a newfound respect for movement watches if you don't know the story. At least it did for me. I get a lot of shit on my YouTube channel whenever I talk about movement watches. People are like really like upset, like, oh, movement, they're cheap watches, you shouldn't promote them, blah, 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 blah. And the truth is, I have always loved movement watches. I love the design. I love the way they look. I love the way that they feel. Like, they have gone through so many different iterations and design changes and improvements lately. And recently, they, this is really cool. They launched this, which is the latest design. It's an automatic watch, right? A super badass automatic watch with a dome crystal, Italian leather, like they're killing it. Price point, like $300. Anyway, today I got done filming a video where I compared movement watches to Rolex. And basically I'm going over like five reasons why I think that movement is better than Rolex. And you know, the video is gonna get a ton of hate. It's gonna have people like automatically without watching the video or listening to me, they're gonna automatically hit that thumbs down button. And while we're talking about thumbs, why don't you hit the thumbs up button for this video and this vlog and what we're trying to do here for the community. We never ask for thumbs up. And I know that it actually does help out the algorithm and all that good stuff. So if you don't mind, hit one of these. Anyway, so I did this video, which I'll post in a few weeks, but the thing that I am so sort of like just astonished by and the story and the takeaway, this is an entrepreneurial tale of epic proportion. In 2013, Movement was started by two dudes, Kramer and this guy Jake, right? They were college kids. They were broke-ass college kids who were like, yo, we love watches, but we don't have the deep enough pockets, we're broke college kids, to buy and spend hundreds of dollars for watches. And so they're like, yo, I wonder if we could, you know, source them in China and figure out a way to create a brand that offers, you know, stylish, cool watches for guys who like cool looking watches that aren't gonna be super expensive. They started doing research and they found out that there is an incredible markup in wristwatches, fashion watches specifically. And I would qualify Movement as a fashion watch. Now, their new design, the automatic watch, now we're talking about a little bit higher end, you know, complication, it's a Miyota Movement, you know, they're really stepping it up. But that's beside the point. So they were like, hey, these guys were like, they were like 19 or like 20 year old, you know, kids. They were like, hey, we wanna see if we can do something. And so instead of going out and asking their parents, and they might ask their parents might have said no, but what they did is they started an Indiegogo campaign that they raised like $230,000. And this was back in 2013 when, you know, Indiegogo and Kickstarter, I think they were easier to sort of get going and get funded. And they did. They got funded, like they well out or they succeeded beyond their wildest dreams, and they created this brand movement. And they quit school, and like a few years later, like their business was doing like $60 million in revenue. And so they went from an idea, college kids, which one of the first points I want to bring up and showcase is the fact that a lot of you guys out there think that, oh, I'm too young, or oh, I don't know enough. These guys educated themselves. They were literally like just out of high school and decided that they wanted to start a business and create, you know, cool looking watches that weren't going to break the bank, that they could afford and that their friends could afford. And so age, they were very young when they did this. In terms of the money, funding is number two. They didn't ask their friends, their family. They went out and they raised it through a Kickstarter type campaign, Indiegogo, and they were successful. And so this goes to the point of, you don't necessarily have to have this deep network of people with a lot of money. If there's a will, a lot of times there is a way, you just need to figure it out. And then the other thing that really has impressed me, the more that I sort of started digging in and researching the company movement, is that they built their business without ever raising additional money. And in today's world, and today's the way that, you know, sort of like internet businesses work, you know, most people that scale are raising money. They self-funded everything, which is inspirational to me, because that's what Tiege Hanley is doing. We're self-funding. We're growing, you know, we're not growing to the level that they're growing to yet, but you know, we're growing and we're doing it ourselves. So 2013, they have an idea, they fund it through a Kickstarter campaign, they grow it to a huge, giant, multi-million dollar business, and then they sell to Movado. They're still involved in the business, and I don't know all of the details. I know some details that I'm not gonna share because it was told to me in confidence, but they killed it, right? They're doing amazing. And one of the beautiful things about, and when I heard about that in terms of Movado and them teaming up, it made total sense to me. When you think about a customer acquisition or a business acquisition, if you're a big customer, you want to attract or acquire a smaller business that gives you a foothold into some place that you're not currently doing well. Movado, for those of you who have never heard of the brand, that was a huge brand, and it's still a huge brand. When I was growing up, you know, when you thought about, oh, you got a Movado, like it had like, you know, a very simple face with like a little like silver bead at the top. Like, you know, if you were something, if you had a little bit of money, if you were Italian from Northeast Philly and drove an IROC, which none of you know what that is, you had a Movado, and it was like, it was a status symbol. You know, the watches were, you know, few hundred bucks to I think like around 1,000, somewhere in that neighborhood. But they have sort of not been on anybody's radar in my eyes or on social media's eyes lately. And so what they did, you know, they have incredible, you know, technology. They've got incredible factories. They're a machine. They're doing giant, giant business. So they were like, hey, we see this company movement who's doing really incredible in the space that we don't have any business being in right now, or that we have not been successful at. And they said, hey, we want to partner with you. And so they went, they negotiated, they did whatever, and they partnered with Movement. And you know, it was all hush hush, and they finally got the deal done. But what this also does for Movement, because I know Jake and Kramer are still working with the company and still a big part of it, they get to do super cool things and have this giant watch manufacturer that has years and years of history and heritage and experience. They're partnering with them. So it is such a beautiful partnership in my eyes. And it just, the whole Movement story, it's so inspiring to me, because it proves that anybody can do it. You don't need rich parents. You don't need, you know, a trust fund. You don't need to have connections in Silicon Valley. If there's a will, there's an idea, there's a way. Gentlemen, Movement, they're killing it. Congrats. And I just think I'm inspired. You know, it's one of those stories. It's one of those businesses. It's one of those brands that inspires me. And I love promoting them. I love the watches. I think they're sick in terms of the styling. Are they as good as a Rolex? No. But guess what? Most people can't afford a Rolex. And even if you can afford it, the thought or the idea that you're going to spend 12 grand on a watch is a little bit nutty, in my opinion. But like I said, Movement, I just dig them. And You know, I think they're doing great, and I am rooting for them, and I'm inspired by them, and so I wanted to talk about the brand. Now, let's get to your questions. So there were like 230 comments on the last vlog, which is amazing, but they're all about deodorant and not about business questions. So I'm gonna finish this video up and tell you about something that happened to me this week that had me pissed off at myself. So a little bit about my work, right? The thing that takes the longest in my day that I spend the most time doing is editing my videos. I have been told on numerous occasions, that's something you should give to somebody else. Give it to somebody else. Give it to somebody else. Have other people edit them. And most people that I know have other people that edit their videos. They film it, they upload it, it sends to somebody, and they do their thing. For whatever reason, I have not wanted to give away that task of mine. I love writing my videos, I love filming my videos, and I like editing them and creating the video. Like, that's why I started doing YouTube videos, and 10 years later, I still love it, and that's part of what I do and what I love doing. The downside is that it was taking me upwards of 2.5 hours a day to edit one video. Now, you're thinking 2.5 hours, that's not too bad if you're familiar with video editing. But that's normal videos. Videos that have fancy edits and overlays and music and all sorts. My videos are so freaking basic. It's basically just dragging things and dropping them into a storyline, cutting them, making sure everything flows, going through doing a rough edit, and then chopping it down to around 6.5 minutes. Because little do you know that the majority of my videos, the first time through, will be like 8 minutes. And then I'm like, all right, I'll chop like 1.5 minutes out of it, you know, in different places just to keep it flowing and going better. And so I have been editing these videos, and I'm staying up until like 11 o'clock at night. It's killing me. But the thing that was killing me about this video editing is the software I was using. I was using it's called PowerDirector 15, which they're on PowerDirector 17 now. I never upgraded, it's by CyberLink. It's a little bit archaic in terms of the editing software. Everybody else is using like better editing software like Final Cut, Final Cut Pro, and all this. I learned on PowerDirector, and actually I learned on Windows Movie Maker, and then I was like, oh, I thought I was something when I upgraded to PowerDirector to try and learn like green screen. So I've been using it, and every time I get a new computer, about once every like 2 years, I'll upgrade to the newest, latest version. Well, the PowerDirector 15 was so freaking slow and buggy and waited and lag and like literally it took me the majority of the time waiting for my editing software. It would crash, it wouldn't like when I play it, it was horrible. My computer also, I got this really nice like Dell like XPS, I forget what exactly model number it was, but it was like 2 years ago and it was super fast at the time. Well, the memory's all gone because of what I do, the editing and all that. So my computer was terrible. My editing software was horrible, but I didn't realize how bad it had gotten because it's sort of one of those like slow burns, right? At first it's a little buggy, but over time you're still using it and it crashed and it was horrible. So I thought to myself, I'm like, okay, Alpha, let's get real. If you're not willing to give up this part of your day or this job, you've got to do it better. You've got to figure out a way to do it faster, because that is really the only place in my day that I could try and save some time. And so I went online, I talked to my computer guy that I know, I found like the latest, you know, Dell XPS. I'm also not an Apple guy, and I know that I'm an idiot for that. Everybody tells me that all the time, but I'm a Dell guy. I like this Dell, I love this last computer. So I found a super fast computer. It had the i9 processor, which was new. It had a SD drive. It had all sorts of bells and whistles. I bought it. It was expensive. It was like $2,300, $2,400. I gave it to my computer guy. He downloaded the newest software of PowerDirector of 17. I edited my first video from 2.5 hours, 28 minutes. I just literally saved 2 hours of my day. Multiply that by 5 days. I just gained an extra day's worth of productivity. Right? Like it was so mind-blowing. Like, and the thing is, the computer's a little messed up, right? The fan is too loud, and my computer guy's like, oh, we can fix it, we'll send it back. I'm like, I can't be without this computer. We gotta order a fan, we'll install it, and all that good stuff. But I literally feel like I found like the greatest thing ever, because I did not know how incredibly important the tools that you're using to do the job are. And that is the business lesson in all of this. You've got to have the right tools in order to be able to be effective and efficient. And if you don't, you're shooting yourself in the foot. And me, for the past like year and a half, have been working with this archaic system that has cost me literally 2 hours a day. And so I just wanted to share that because it was so mind blowing to me. I'm still like, I'm so excited now to edit. I'm like, all right, start the clock. Now yesterday's edit, a little more involved. It took like 45 minutes, but still that one would have taken me like 3.5 hours because the software sucks so bad. Gentlemen, I'm an idiot. That's the other lesson of the day. But I'm learning. And see, the other thing about me, I'm a late adopter, right? I am very, not fearful of technology, but I don't like learning new things. One of the reasons why I don't switch to like Final Cut or some of these other video editing softwares is that I don't want to have to learn it. And for me to learn anything new is just like, it's hours or days or whatever that I'm not going to be as productive. So that's why I'm a bonehead and I don't switch to anything new. But don't be like me. I'm an idiot. But I realized how much of an idiot I am now because of what just happened with this editing software. Guys, that's it for me. I don't know if you got anything from this vlog other than the fact that I'm a fanboy of the two guys who run the company Movement, and I'm an idiot because I was scared of change. Guys, I need your help. Next week, much more Tiege information down in the comments, business questions. If you've got one, let us know. Start it with business question and then ask your question. This vlog is about you. Today was about me. I'm sorry. I had some things I wanted to talk about and you didn't have any questions. So instead of, you know, I need you to help. Gentlemen, you're amazing. You're beautiful. Thank you so much. If you have not checked out Tiege Handley, there's a link down below to Tiege.com. Get handsome. It works. We love you more than our double monk strap shoes. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you next week.